untangling. Alright.
What is it you're spinning?
Sheep's wool.
Just general sheep's wool.
Yeah.
Alright.
Somebody asked me what sheep it came from. And...
Because people give us fleeces and some we have to buy.
So it's whatever we can get our hands on, really. I think my hands must be getting tired.
Probably. I think it takes most of the morning.
Where did you learn to spin?
I actually learnt at the new museum.
Right.
It was a case of, here's a spinning wheel, this is what you need to do.
All right.
Take it from there.
Yeah.
But it's really, I mean, I'm very, very new to it.
Right.
And it's mostly a matter of practice. A lot depends on the wool you've got.
Some of
it's longer than others.
Yeah.
And the longer it is, the easier it is. But I'm getting now and I can get long runs and it goes quite smoothly. It's very pleasing.
Have you got a bookmark?
Oh, thanks, Sus.
So, you know, you really go to Sus and some of the reenactment shows and biking things.
Yeah, yeah.
And you look at the materials they've got. They're all hand spun, hand woven, and you think, skilled to get to that level, it really takes.
Yeah.
And at the moment, it's the worst sort of club school.
Might be your carding.
Oh, probably is. I think I've done this a bit too quick.
Yeah.
Just have some on, really.
How do you card it?
The old fashioned way.
I think it's your preparation. I think it's your carding.
It could be.
It's making it difficult.
I'll have to do more combing.
Yeah. Do you put oil in it?
Sorry.
Do you put oil in your wool?
It's unwashed.
Right.
So it's got all the lanolin in it that comes off the sheet.